So we're going to do the first one, policy results. We're going to right click here. We're going to click on group policy results wizard. It's going to load this up. You can read it. I'm going to click next here. You have two options, disk computer, which is the local computer. We're not going to do that. We're going to do another computer. So I'm going to click on browse, and then you type in the name of the computer, which is PC02 is the computer that we want to grab the GP results from. We're going to click OK. We're going to click next here. Awesome. And then it gives you a list. Because my Active Directory, my lab is so small, these are all the users that I have within my lab. So the one that I want is Bruce Wayne. I want to get the GP results for Bruce Wayne. So let's click next here. Gives you a nice little summary of what's going to happen. Once you click next, boom, let it be, and then click finish. And then on your right hand side, it's going to generate the report for Bruce Wayne on PC02. This is the way that you want it. This is how you should run GP results on computers and for user accounts to actually see what's going on, what type of GPOs are being hit. And this gives you a nice good summary. And let's click on show all, which will expand everything. This will actually give you a nice view. What GPOs are failing? Which ones are success? Why? When was the last time that group policies hit? For the computer policy, it was 2:17, 10:16 a.m., which was about an hour ago. The user policy was around 10:30. So that new policy that we did on that computer is not going to hit until an hour or so. We are able to force it, maybe do a reboot, right, and see if that policy will hit. It shows you all the policies that it's winning, which is awesome. I got my certificate, my default. How easy is that? And apply GPO, disabled CMD access was applied. This is good. That's good. It was applied. Awesome. So if I go inside PC02 and we go CMD and we click on it, it should load up, but we should get this. This is what we want. Bam. The command prompt has been disabled by the administrator. So right click on it. Group policy modeling wizard, run it, click next. I only have one domain controller, so I'm gonna leave it as the available controller. Click next here. This is where you are able to actually select what containers or users that you want. Let's do containers. Let's do browse, see user. Let's click OK. Container, computer, let's do container for the computers. Let's do workstations, right? Boom, boom, boom. Click next. For the site, I'm going to do the default. You are able to do a slow network connection or do a loopback processing. I'm not going to do that as of now. We could click next here. You are able to break it down to security groups. I'm going to do it authenticated users. Click next here. Computer, security groups. I'm going to leave it as authenticated users. If you have any WMI filters for users, you are able to list your WMI filters here. I don't have any, so I'm going to leave it as the default. Same thing for computers. I don't have any filters, but you are able to play around with that. Click next. A nice little summary. Click next. And again, this is another way to play around with the settings. So users on workstations, any users that within this OU and on this workstation, they're going to get these policies. This is what's going to happen. These are the type of policies that they're going to get. That's it for episode 60. I wanted to make it kind of short and sweet. And that's about it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this episode. And I catch you guys on the next The Server Room. Peace out. All right. So I always forget how to stop this.